Students, today we are going to learn one more problem in relation to the turnover ratios. Look at the board. Calculate inventory turnover ratio, trade receivable turnover ratio, trade payable turnover ratio, fixed assets turnover ratio. Particulars, opening balances and closing balances are given. Inventory opening, closing, trade receivable opening, closing, trade payable opening balances, closing balance, fixed asset opening balance and closing balances are given. Additional information, revenue from operation 10,50,000, purchase during the year 4,50,000, cost of revenue from operation 6,00,000. Assume all sales and purchases are for credit. Okay. Revenue from operation means sales. So they are saying assume the total revenue from operation as credit sales. Then we have to assume purchases also as credit. Now we are going to solve the first ratio called inventory turnover ratio. One, inventory turnover ratio. Formula, cost of revenue from operation, cost of revenue from operation divided by average inventory. Average inventory. In this problem, cost of revenue from operation, cost of revenue from operation given 6,00,000. So we have to find average inventory. For average inventory, the formula is opening inventory plus closing inventory divided by 2. Opening inventory 1,40,000, closing inventory 1,00,000 divided by 2. So 2,40,000 divided by 2 equal to 1,20,000. So our average inventory is 1,20,000. Now we are going to apply the formula. We know cost of revenue from operation 6,00,000. Our average inventory 1,20,000. Our answer is 5 times. So our inventory turnover ratio is 5 times. Then second ratio, trade receivable turnover ratio. Second ratio, they are asking trade receivable turnover ratio. Trade receivable turnover ratio. Formula, credit revenue from operation. Credit revenue from operation divided by average accounts receivable. In this problem, credit revenue from operation is given. Credit revenue from operation is given. We have to find average trade receivable or average accounts receivable. What is the formula of average trade receivable? Here, opening trade receivable and closing trade receivable are given. So formula is opening trade receivable plus closing trade receivable divided by 2. Opening trade receivable 80,000, closing trade receivable 60,000 divided by 2. So 1,40,000 divided by 2, our average trade receivable is 70,000. As we know, credit revenue from operation is about 10,50,000. Our average trade receivable is 70,000. So our answer is 15 times. Okay. The third question, trade payable turnover ratio. Third question, trade payable turnover ratio. Formula, net credit purchase divided by average trade payables. In this problem, net credit purchases are given. So we have to find average trade payable. Formula for average trade payable formula, opening trade payable plus closing trade payable divided by 2. Opening trade payable 40,000. Closing trade payable 50,000 divided by 2 equal to 90,000 divided by 2. 45,000 is average trade payable. Now our credit purchases, we know 4,50,000. Our average trade payable is 45,000. So our answer is 10 times. This is trade payable turnover ratio. Then last ratio, fourth one, fixed assets turnover ratio. Fourth one, fixed assets turnover ratio. Formula for this, revenue from operation divided by average fixed assets. In this problem, revenue from operation as well as credit revenue from operation, both are same. So revenue from operation given in the question, we have to find average fixed assets. Since opening and closing balances are given, we have to use opening fixed assets plus closing fixed assets divided by 2. Opening fixed assets 5,50,000. Closing fixed asset 5 lakh divided by 2. So 10,50,000 divided by 2. 5,25,000 is average fixed asset. We know revenue from operation, its value 10,50,000. Average fixed asset 5,25,000. So our answer is 2 times. In this problem, only one problem, which includes inventory turnover ratio, trade receivable turnover ratio, trade payable turnover ratio, and fixed assets turnover ratio. Students, we completed turnover ratio. In next class, we'll solve different problem. Till then, bye and thank you.